it's nice to see them able to win games, but they, you know, I was confident that, you know, once they began to have belief in themselves and in them as a team, that we'd be able to win games. Now, obviously, you know, they won't, you know, the win streaks will come to an end and we're going to lose games too. But it's nice to see this early in the season that they've already started to find some of that belief in what they can do as a group.
What are the pitfalls that are out there now that they're having this kind of success?
Well, the scary things would be that you stop doing the little things that gets you those wins. You know, you start getting overconfident, you stop playing as hard and competing as hard. And, you know, that's kind of a natural progression when teams go on winning streaks. And the winning kind of covers up a lot of the mistakes you're making. But for us, we're going to do our best to keep pointing those out and keep trying to grow as a team. And, you know, we're going to stay on the guys. And they've been great. They've been in film sessions. They're taking accountability for stuff. So, you know, hopefully we won't get too much slippage.
Is Julius Randle having a breakout year?
I mean, it's six. How many games have we played? Seven games. But he's been very good. He's been very good. But I think it's a little early to call it a breakout year.
What do you like from him so far?
I love the way he's pushing the ball. I love the way he's growing as a defender. You know, to me, he can be an absolute elite defender in this league with his size and strength and quickness. And he's starting to see things, and when he switches, defend guards better. So it's good to see that growth in that part of his game.
When you started the season with JC and Lou on the bench, is this exactly what you envisioned?
This is what we were seeing in the preseason with that second unit, but I did not envision it. You know, this is kind of, kind of just naturally happened. We didn't really know how we were going to, you know, play. We knew JC and Lou were both playing great for us, but it's tough to, you know, to play two, you know, shooting guards, especially, on the smaller size of shooting guards together at the same time. And B.I.'s ability to kind of guard multiple positions and the fight that J.C. and Lou have showed on the defensive end has allowed that lineup to kind of grow together. But I definitely hadn't envisioned it. It kind of just took place.
And, of course, at the center position, Mozgov is giving you something that the Lakers haven't had here for a few years, and that is great fundamentals, like when Powell was here.
Mozgov's been great for us. I mean, he's protecting our paint. He's running the lane. He's unselfish. He had a pass in last night's game where he was rolling down the middle and he found Nick Young in the weak side corner for a wide open shot. He's done a fabulous job of anchoring that defensive unit and getting us extra possessions and finishing around the rim for us on offense.
Is your team, even though it's very young, are they mature enough not to believe the hype and all the noise?
Finding out. It's new for all of us. So they've continued to prove so far that they are. But it only gets more challenging as the season goes on. We just lost Larry Nance. He's a huge part of what we do, especially with that second unit, with the way he sees the game. He covers up a lot of things for us. There'll be challenges throughout the year, and we'll see how we approach those challenges as a group.
Are you already talking to them about that, about not getting caught up in?
Absolutely. Yeah, we talk about everything, whatever it is. If we think it could be an issue, or if there's something we're not doing and it is an issue, we try to get it out there and deal with it.
Are you optimistic Larry can play Thursday at Sacramento?
Yeah, I am, but I'm not the doctor. So there's concussion protocol, which has got like three different tiers, and when they say he's cleared to play, it's really, it's not up to him how he's feeling. It's more when he passes these tests. So I have no idea. I'm hoping he'll be back Thursday, but if not, we'll keep plugging in until he gets back.
You guys have not won three home games in a row since 2013. How important is kind of reestablish a little bit of a home court edge?
I think it's very important. I think, you know, we talked about it before the Houston game, and I said win or lose, we need to start setting a tone that if teams are coming into Staples Center, they're going to have to take that win because we're not giving anything away here. And to start 3-0 at home, I think, is a great standard for our guys.
The fact that you guys are winning games despite the turnovers and the fouls, does that tell you that maybe you guys are a little bit ahead of schedule?
Yeah, because it's hard to win games in this league. And it's near impossible to win games when you foul all the time and you turn the ball over as much as we have. But somehow our guys keep finding a way. You know, the exciting thing about that to me is that if we're finding ways to win the game and we're doing that, if we can continue to commit and continue to get better at those, you know, those things that are hurting us, then we only give ourselves a much better chance of winning more games.
Coach, do you sometimes have to slow them down because of their thirst for knowledge and experience?
Yeah, and it's more of, you know, there's a lot we want to continue to put in, but we're just not doing it yet. We'll put in a little bit here and there, but most of our time in practice gets spent on what we've already done and trying to continue to get better at our basic ideas on both ends of the court.
Talk it up, guys.
Is it kind of crazy how quick the narrative in the NBA can change?
In all sports, you know, but it can change just as quickly the other direction. If we lose three in a row, all the stories will be the same again about a young team that's trying to figure it out. So, you know, again, I've said it from the beginning, we're trying not to get caught up in all that and not worry about that and just focus on what we do as a group, win or lose, continue to move in a certain direction and let the rest of the world say what they're going to say.